This video demonstrates the procedure for putting this Toshiba Chromebook 2 into developer mode by disabling OS verification. An external monitor is connected to show which parts of this procedure are visible in the external monitor. And a phone running the stopwatch app is here to give us a sense of time because I'll be fast forwarding through the boring bits. First, I'm gonna turn off a Chrome OS running in normal mode. Now I'm gonna start the developer mode, escape, refresh. Before I hit power, I will start the timer. This starts the procedure. It will ask for verification to disable. Oh no, this is the Chrome OS missing is down. This is a recovery screen. From here, we hit Control D to say disable OS verification. And then here we get the OS verification screen. Are we sure? We hit return to say we are sure. Then we get the OS verification is off. Press space to re-enable. We do not want to re-enable. We hit Control D to proceed into transitioning to developer mode. This screen, as far as I can tell, is a are you sure wait timeout. There's nothing to do from this point on except to wait it out. When wait through the procedure, this will take about 7 minutes. Watch the stopwatch. I'm recording this video because I got this Chromebook with a broken screen that was completely illegible. I was able to connect the external monitor and use it as a Chromebox. And that worked until I wanted to put it into developer mode and realized that these menus for developer mode are only visible on that primary screen, which was cracked and unreadable. I looked online to see if somebody has documented the procedure for doing it while possibly blind and unable to read the screen. I did not find anything, so I'm making this video to help somebody who was in the position I was 2 weeks ago. I have since then bought a replacement screen and installed it, and that's why we can see the screen now. There will be about 5 minutes of this progress bar going. I will be fast forwarding through this part. Watch the timer. Roughly 6.5 minutes after we started the procedure, the computer is now in developer mode with OS verification turned off. Of course, if this was me 2 weeks ago with a screen that's unreadable, I would not know this. The first hint would be two beeps in this OS verification off is off screen. There they are. After the beep, it will proceed to boot into Chrome OS with developer mode. So if I did not have the primary screen, this would be my first indication something has worked correctly. External monitor is active and I can push the mirror keystroke again and I can see enable debugging features. That's how I would know it's successfully into developer mode. Now, once that is set up, you don't need to wait for the double beep. When we turn it on, oh, we can stop the timer now. When we turn it on, it will come up with the OS verification off screen, nothing on the external monitor. We can hit Control D to skip the 30-second timeout. And here it is, booted up. Hit the mirror external screen, and there it is, enable debugging features. Of course, eventually you might want to get out of debug developer mode and go back to normal Chrome OS functionality. And we'll record how to do that too. Power off. And what happens is, instead of pressing Control D, we'll press a different keystroke at the initial screen. Start the timer, power. Here's OS verification off screen. Press space to re-enable. We press space and then press enter to confirm OS verification come back on. Switching OS verification back on is significantly faster. Less than a minute. And now we can hit the mirror key again. Everything is back up, and there is not the enable debugging features option telling us we're back in normal Chrome OS mode, not in developer mode. Secured OS verification is on. So that's how you get into and out of developer mode on a Toshiba Chromebook 2 with the keystrokes and timing documented, just in case you want to do this on a Chromebook with a broken primary screen. I hope this helps somebody, like it would have helped me 2 weeks ago.